first got here, I had 12 players. So within 6 months, I had to recruit 13 guys. So the biggest thing was changing the culture and making the guys believe in themselves, because there was certainly talent within those 12 guys. But you know, we had to, in terms of our style of play, we had to play a little bit more direct. And over time, we've tried to slowly, you know, eradicate some of the big ego guys that played for themselves and not for the group. I think just trying to stay humble and still find our own identity. It's a, you know, completely different team, a completely new year, and we're just trying to manage egos at this point and find players' roles and responsibilities within our system, deal with adversities with injuries and other things that come up, and try and stay as focused game by game that we can be. I think we're exactly where we thought we would be at this point, so there's no surprises there. I think our focus is just getting better as a group and in practice. And I think the more that we play together, the more that we train together, the better we'll be, and the results will come. I expect going forward, as long as we can manage our health, that we're still going to be in a position to contend for championships in the end. Ryan's been with our program since spring 2009, and we're very, very happy that his relationship has grown and extended outside of our program. It's really nice to see other programs in our conference sort of doing the same thing. I think there's a lot of benefits to not only our program but to our conference as well, and I think it's immeasurable what that relationship has done for us. Yeah, I would love to have Ryan. I'd love to have Ryan every day, but obviously it's not possible. But hopefully, if we make it to that point again, this new community will be gracious enough to support that effort in getting him down, because I think it has a great impact on our success on the field.
Ryan. I believe that Ryan.
I believe that Ryan will.
I believe that Ryan will.
I believe that Ryan will win.
I believe that Ryan will win. I believe that Ryan will win.
Well, I mean, outside of his, you know, his inability to see, you know, his attitude is just infectious. I think that his approach to life is something that our guys can take a lot from, and you know, having him go through you know, what he's gone through in terms of another tumor going back, having to go through chemo, and how he reacted to that and how he still stayed the same person has just brought that lesson to another level for our guys. And the strength that he has is definitely you know, had an effect on our run last year, and I think our group in general, especially a lot of the younger guys that you know, have some room to mature and grow and haven't seen a lot of things outside of the normal day-to-day program things or in life in general. So it's nice to have that experience with him and to share in a lot of memories together. I think giving him some normalcy, something to look forward to, and something to get excited about, something to take his mind away from what else is going on. And you know, every year he meets a new crop, comes in, he meets new guys, and he still continues the relationship with guys that have left. And so just gives him a lot of older brothers type personalities to sort of look up to and bond with. And
I believe that we have won. I believe that we have won.